Hello viewers, welcome back to the card mart. I'm going to show you a nice four ace trick now by Frank Garcia. But first off, I want to draw your attention to the pack. Now it's just a normal pack. I've got no smoke, no mirrors, no trap doors, no hidden assistants, no white rabbits, nothing like that. Right, now I did say it was a four ace trick. So for it, obviously, I'm going to need the four aces. So you just bear with me while I go through and get them out. Because I want to do it this way to show that it's all fair. I mean, you've seen the pack, you've seen that it's not in any set order, and as I say, there's no hidden things in there at all. Right. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to lose these four aces back into the pack in four different ways, and then I'll find them again in four different ways. Sounds easy when you say it quick. But anyway, let's see. If I break off a little pack for that ace, and break off a little pack for that ace, and break off a little pack for that ace, and a little pack for that ace. Now to lose them. We'll start with the club, and what I'll do is fan the cards out, and we'll take the ace of clubs, and what we'll do is we'll just lose that into the middle of the fan. Get it lost. We'll put the ace of diamonds on the top of that pack, and put that pack on the top of the ace of diamonds. For the ace of hearts, we'll put his pack on the top of there, which we'll put him then on the top of, and we'll cut him into the middle of the pack. For the ace of spades, we'll just stick him on like that, put them on the top, and we'll lose him in. So we've just lost the aces, as I said, in four different ways. And as you can see, I'm not holding any breaks, so I don't know where any of them are. Now we've got to try and find them in four different ways. So let's start with an indicator. And if you don't know what an indicator is, it's a card whose value tells you where the selected card is, in this case, an ace. So obviously if it was a three cards away, we'll find an ace. If it was a nine cards away, we'll find an ace. If it was one of the picture cards, well, a jack is 11, a queen is 12, and king is 13. Right, so first we need to get one of the cards which is in the correct position away from an ace to reveal itself. And I find the best way of doing it is just giving that back corner a little riffle like that. Now if I start spreading through, we shall find that a card actually reveals itself. And there we go, seven of hearts, revealed itself in the middle. Now it doesn't matter so much that it's a heart. All we're interested in is the value, and that's a seven. So that's telling us seven cards down is an ace. One, two, three, four, five, six. Seventh card down, ace of clubs. Right, so we just found the first one using an indicator. Well, let's try and find the second one without the indicator. Let's see if we can get the second one just to reveal itself the way the indicator did. So again, just give the cards a bit of a ripple at the back corner and have a look through again. And hopefully we see something a bit more interesting than just blue backs. And we do. We find another ace. Ace of diamonds. So that's the ace of clubs found with an indicator. The ace of diamonds found by indicating itself. So should we go for, let's see, go for the ace of hearts next. And for the ace of hearts, we'll just do a spell. So we'll just go A-C-E for ace, O-F for of, and H-E-A-R-T. And if we take the S, we shall find that's the ace of hearts. Right, that just leaves us with the ace of spades. And the ace of spades, he's a bit of a tricky bugger. He likes making me work. He doesn't like being found in a conventional way. He likes a lot of effort. Basically, a lot of shuffling. So that's what we do. We give the ace of spades a chance to find himself. So we just give them a couple of shuffles, and say we give them a cut while it's like that. If we just click over them and pick them up, we should find one card decides to come out the middle of the pack. And you did see that coming out the middle, but I hope you did anyway. And that card, oh, I missed with that one, just happens to be the ace of spades. So as I say, four aces, lost into the pack four different ways, and then found again in four different ways. I hope you enjoyed that. And if you want to see the tutorial, stick around, it's coming next. If you don't want to see the tutorial, I'll see you again soon. Well, I hope some of you have stuck around for this tutorial, otherwise I'm talking to myself, as per usual. Nice little 4-ace one by Frank Garcia. And there is a slight setup to it. I mean, you can do it impromptu if you want to. You basically need your four aces and you need a seven. That's it. I say, if you want to do it impromptu, all you do, just look through your pack. And when you find the seven, just cut it at the top. So you've got the seven on the top of the pile. I'll get that off there now, it might be confusing. Right, so there's your basic setup. Well, the basic cards you need. You take your seven, whichever one you want to use. It doesn't have to be the heart, it can be any suit you want. And put that straight onto the top of the pack. Turn the pack over. And have your aces in this order. So the top one on a face-up pile is your spade. Then a heart, then a diamond, and then a club. You can, if you want to, reverse them two around. It doesn't really make any difference. But you definitely need your spade and your heart on the top. And all you do is lose them into the pack in that order, in a face-up pack. So when you start looking through, the first one you'll find is the spade, then a heart, diamond, and a club. So you just put them anywhere you want to in the pack, anywhere you want to. So you, as you can see, the four aces are going in different orders. Spade, heart, diamond, and club. Now I always start this off by spreading them out, because the first way you're going to find the card is with a reversed card in the middle somewhere. So if you spread the cards out to start with, they can see that they're all facing in the same direction, and it does stick in the head that they're just seeing a face down pack. You can spread them that way as well, just to show that it is completely random. It doesn't matter that they can see the aces, they can see that they're all separated everywhere. And it doesn't matter about the seven at the end, because nobody's going to pay much attention to that. Anyone's just going to be looking to see where the aces are, basically. Then all you do is say that you're going to do the four ace trick, and you need four aces. So you just go through, and you take out the four aces. Spade. Heart. Diamond. And when you get into the club, as you're putting the club down, you need to get a break underneath that seven on the top card. So you just do a pinky pull down, just to get a break on that seven. Or pull in with your first finger at the top, and it just buries that seven down. Again, just so you can get a pinky break on it. So you get a pinky break on it as you're putting that ace down. You put all these on, and they're in a bit of a mess. So under the process of squaring them up, all you're doing is pulling your hand back and putting the seven into a gambler's cup. So you've got all of it. But make sure you don't have your hand down like that. I mean, obviously, if I was in front of you, you wouldn't be able to see that. And bend it in, so it goes into the shape of your palm. But if you've got it sticking out like that, it's harder to hide. Whereas if it goes in, it's easier. Yeah. So you just bend that in a bit. As you pull that pack up, and if you want to, you can hold it there for a bit, but don't turn your hand too far that way either, because you'll see it sticking out. And then all you're doing is just turning that pack over on top of that seven. So you now have that seven face up on the bottom. Then what I do is talk about I'm going to lose the cards in four different ways, and then find them again in four different ways. And while I'm doing that, all I'm doing is shuffling nine cards to the bottom. So I just shuffle them off, one, two, and three. I'm going to lose the cards in four different ways. I deal another three off, and keep separating your hands out the way. So, because if you keep them together, they might get onto what you're doing. So every time you do three, separate them away, pull them back, do another three cards, pull it away again. And when you come back this time, all you're doing is dropping that pack on the top of them, but leaving these out jogged a little bit at the back. So just turn your hand up slightly as you put them down, and that hides them sticking out. If your hand's too flat down, they'll see them. So just have your hand up a bit. And be careful as you put it down that bottom card, because that's your face up seven, doesn't get caught as you put them on the pack. You know, so it sticks out and they can see it. So you want to get that on so they can't see that. Then all you're going to do is push down on them nine cards there and get a thumb break like that. So you've got a thumb break, which you then turn into a pinky break. Because now you're going to split it into four packs. And you've got them nine cards at the bottom, so there's one pack. So what you've got to do is split this top pack into three. So you take about a third off it and put them down under the spade. Then whatever's left, just break roughly into half. Put them under the heart. Then you take everything above the break and put them down there. And that's got your face up seven on the bottom. So be careful not to split that as you put it down so they can get a glimpse of the card. And then them nine cards, which were on the bottom, they just go underneath the ace of clubs. They say, we're going to lose them now in four different ways. So we'll start with the ace of clubs. And you just do a fan. Take the ace of clubs and run it across them. And when it just gets past that fourth card, you just pull it in. So it's going in between the third and the fourth card. And you pull it to the middle. But it's still trapped, that bottom corner is still trapped behind the third card, so it's still, the ace is still in fourth place. So you pull it in and show it it's in the middle, close it up and push it in. So you've actually put the ace fourth to the bottom, but they think it's somewhere in the middle. You're right, so we've just lost the first one in the middle of a fan. To lose the ace of diamonds, we'll just put that on the top of that pile. Now be careful when you pick this up that you don't flash that card on the bottom, either by leaving it behind or dropping something like that. So you just pick that pack up and you just put that straight on the top. So I've just lost the ace of diamonds by putting it on and putting another pack on the top. Now for the ace of hearts, and as you're saying all this, you pick this pack up, you go, and as for the ace of hearts, we lose that a bit different. So you just put the ace of hearts pack onto the pile. Do a wrist kill, because you just want to get a break on that top card, a little pinky break on that top card. And all you're doing is just pushing over with your thumb and then pulling it back and catching the break. So just push over, pull back, and you've got the break. As you're picking the ace up, because their eyes are going to be on your hand going there. And with you've wrist killed anyway, so they're not going to notice just that little push off, pull back, and pinky break. So you pick the ace of the heart up and just put that onto the top face down. Turn your pinky break into a thumb break. And then you're just doing a double undercut, but be careful doing your double undercut that you don't inadvertently. I won't be able to do it now, will I? I'm trying to show you. So you don't inadvertently cut to that face up seven. Because the last thing you want to do is break them off at that seven. Oh, come here, where are you? There, you don't want to be breaking it off at that seven to pull them to the top, if you see what I mean. So always make sure that you break above the seven, put them to the top, still keeping your break. Then you take everything from underneath the break and bring that to the top. Right, now for the ace of spades, you say you're just going to put that onto that pile, leave it out jogged, put that pack onto the top, and then just pull it in. You'll have to work out how to do that. It does take a bit of time to get used to the position on it, but you should get it. You just pull the ace into the pack. So then you say, now I've just lost the four aces, four different ways, and as you can see, I'm not holding any breaks. You say, let's see, now we need to find them in four different ways. First way, using an indicator. Now you've already got that seven face up in the middle. So you just say you're going to riffle the back corner, but make sure that it's out of sight, because the last thing you want to do is riffle down it and they get a glimpse of a face-up card. So you do it so that they can't see what you're doing. And then you just spread through, pushing chunks off at a time, till you get to the seven, and push the next couple of cards over with it. Because what you want to do is pull it back and get a break under them two cards. So you've got a break under the seven and your ace of diamonds. So you spread them off, you spread them off like that. And then as you're pulling it back, you're just catching a break. You're just pushing your little finger up on that second card underneath that ace as you pull them back to get a pinky break. And tap that pack onto them, and it makes it look like it's a square pack, it's all flat. Then put them down, but make sure they're facing up, because you're going to be putting this on there facing up, and you're taking that ace of diamonds with you. So then the ace of diamonds ends up face up. If you see what he wants it to turn over, it's face up, isn't it? So you go, so we've got a seven, and just slide the two cards forward as you re-grip and point out. You know, it doesn't matter so much that it's a heart. We're only transfer it into that hand, but we're only interested in it being a seven. And put them down, but be careful that they don't split, because you've got the face up, the face down ace underneath that. So you put them square onto the pack. Then you say, so seven cards down will be an ace. Then you just count six cards onto there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And do it pretty scruffily, just so that when you put them down, if you're trying to do it neatly, the cards might slide and they'll get a glimpse of the back of a card. Gives the game away. So then you take the seventh card and show it to the ace of clubs. Turn these over and put them on face up, close up and pull back. Then you said that you're going to find the next one by letting it indicate itself, basically. So again, you do your little ripple thing at the back, or whatever you feel happy with, you know, clicking over or getting your little white bunny to dance. And then you spread through until you find the ace, and everything above the ace you put straight to the bottom, and you take the ace of diamonds off. Now straight away, now your ace of hearts is in the pack right where it spell ace of hearts. I've gone too far there, haven't I? A-C-E-O-F-H-E-A-R-T, hearts. Right, so that's already in position. So you can now do some false cuts. You couldn't really do them before because you had a face up seven in the pack and you had a face up ace in the pack, and there's always that chance that you will cut to it. So on the first, until you found that ace of diamonds, don't do any cuts unless you're certain you're not going to cut to one. But now there's no face up cards in the pack, you can do false cuts as long as you don't alter the order of the pack. Then you say you're going to find the next one by spelling it. So you go, we've just had the red one, let's go for the other red one. Then you spell it out. A-C-E for ace, O-F for of, H-E-A-R and T. And when you get to the S, you know you're on your ace of hearts. And these cards go to the bottom of the pack, because right now you're left with an indifferent card and your ace of spades. And what you need to do is get your ace of spades to the bottom. The way I done it in the performance was I just shuffled off the top card, slid it onto the bottom of the pack as I slid off the second card, which is the ace of spades, and then just shuffled on top of the ace of spades. So I just got it to the bottom. You can use any method you like, but this is the way I do it because I think this looks really, really fair. Shuffle the top card off, slide it onto the bottom of the pack as you slide off the next card, which is the ace of spades, and then slide off, shuffle off everything else. Then I give it another shuffle. So I just done a bottom retention. I just held that ace there with my fingers as I slid the top card. As you can see there, I'm just sliding the top and bottom cards together, keeping the ace on the bottom, and then you just shuffle off the rest of the pack. So again, you got your ace on the bottom. Then you go into a table riffle. So you just put them down and break them into half. Remember which is your bottom half of the pack, because that's got your ace on, because you've got to drop the ace down first. So then you just do ace down. Wow, I dropped two there. Ace down and riffle the rest in. And then just push it in so they're only just in. If you can see what I mean, they're only just going into each other. You don't want them all the way in like that. You just want them sort of just in like that. Then you pick up, which is this pack on your left hand side, your right hand side, sorry, and you just angle it slightly. Because by doing that, you're leaving that one card, the Ace of Spades, there. And as you can see, I'm only holding that side, because that side's all trapped. So you just pick up from that pack there and angle it slightly. And you just slide it across so that you're actually putting that ace right in the middle. Yeah, I don't know if you can see that. That ace is going right in the middle of them, that pack. So again, all you do is just pick that up slightly, slide it across and put it down. Then you break off half of the pack and put it on in front. Then pick that up. I mean, you can see the position the ace is in now. There's about half a card that way and about half a card that way. And you put that onto the top. So now when you grab hold of the pack there, if you just give it a little movement, you can feel the edges. Don't wobble too much, you're moving the position. You can feel, I'll try and do it that way. You can see that half the ace is sticking out that side there. And if I try and do it again that way, now the pack's all moving. The ace is sticking out halfway that way, right? So I'll go through that again. You break it off, you riffle down just the first card off the bottom pack. If you riffle down more than one by accident, carry on the shuffle, put it together, just do a complete shuffle, and then do it again. Break it off in half, because your ace is still on the bottom. And again, drop one, and shuffle them in together. Just put them in just slightly. Just tilt that pack slightly up, and slide it across so that they go halfway across the ace. Break half the pack off, pick the ace up, again it's in position, and put that on the top. Then all you do is just hold the pack roughly halfway down this side and halfway down that side. So you're holding it roughly in the middle of each of the packs. So now all you're going to do is twist your hand. Don't grip them too tight. All you're going to do is twist your hand out and do a little circular motion, which gets the card to spin. One, riffle them in, just get them in just slightly, pick it up, move it across, break in half, put them onto the top, pick it up nice and lightly, and I'll do this one quicker, and you just do that movement. So all you're doing is just pulling your right hand forward as your left hand comes back, and once, it's not going to work doing that way. There's no easy way to set this up to show you. I've got to go through the entire motion. So you get it together. Oops. Break it in half. Put that onto the top. Grab it very lightly, halfway down both packs. And all you do is pull that out. Get it to there. And with it being quicker, it does spin as it comes out. It gives a little spin. And then you can reveal that that is the last ace. And there we have it. Four aces. Lost four ways, found four ways. I hope you've enjoyed it. It's not that hard to do. There's no real bad slights in it. I wouldn't say it was a beginner trick. It's more of an advanced beginner. But surely you can cope with it. With that, I'll see you soon.